Hello friends and welcome to my channel M Square Analysis Project. So today we are going to see about what is natural coordinates and why we use natural coordinates, and then we will see natural coordinates for one dimensional and two dimensional. So please subscribe to my channel M Square Analysis Project. So today we are going to see about the natural coordinates. Why we use these natural coordinates? So first of all, in finite element analysis, there is a lot of terms which are calculated by using integration of a shape functions. These shape functions are having different powers. So likewise, we are going to find out different shape functions, and according to that, we have to find out the terms. So it is easy to calculate integration of the shape functions having x, y, z coordinates, but it is very easy if we have shape function in the form of natural coordinates. That's why we use these natural coordinates. Now, introduction of a natural coordinates is very easy. Means if we define the natural coordinate system, then it will be easy for calculations. Third is individual local coordinate system. Means if we define this natural coordinate, then it will be a individual. Means for each element we will define one natural coordinate system, so that it is easy for getting calculations for each element. Dimensionless. It is one of the best benefit we are having. Dimensionless means natural coordinates are dimensionless. Then magnitude. Maximum absolute magnitude of this natural coordinate system is unity. Means it's vary from maximum 1 to minimum minus 1. And this is having absolute value of minus 1 is a unity. Means maximum absolute magnitude is unity for this natural coordinates. So let's see about one dimensional natural coordinate. Let's take one example of a one dimensional element having node 1, 2, 2, and there is a point P in between these 1 and 2. Now we are going to introducing the natural coordinate system for this one dimensional element. Now how to calculate this one dimensional element, natural coordinates for this one dimensional element? Let's see. This is a point P which is in between node 1 and 2. So from this point to node number 2, this is called as a length L1. See, for this node 1, opposite to that length is called as a L1. Now this is the length L2, means opposite to the node 2, this is called as a length L2. And total length of this element is a L. Now this is the L1 and L2 are the natural coordinates. For one dimensional element, we are going to use two natural coordinates. So first natural coordinate for first node, that is given by, this is the L1 which is opposite to node 1 divided by total length of the element, L1 divided by L. And second natural coordinate is calculated by using opposite to the node 2, L2, divided by total length. So this is L2 divided by L, and this natural coordinate is equals to shape function of a node 1, and L2 is equal to shape function of a node 2. So L1 equal to N1, L2 is equal to N2. So these are called as a natural coordinates. Now if we find out the coordinate of this point P, X, so X is the coordinate of this point P, which can be find out using this formula L1 x1 plus L2 x2. So this equation can be related to same shape function equation, that is N1 x1 plus N2 x2. Here N1 and N2 are the shape function, and here L1 and L2 are the natural coordinate of one dimensional element. Okay. Similarly, we are going to see the natural coordinate for two dimensional element. In two dimensional element, triangular element is mostly used. Now this is a one triangular element having node 1, 2 and 3. So node numbers are given in anti-clockwise direction. More about this triangular element, just click on the I button here to get the information about the triangular element. Now in this natural coordinate system for two dimensional, what we will do, take a point P in within this triangular element P. Now we will join this point from these nodes, and for node 1 opposite to that area, so this is the triangle which is opposite to node 1 is called as a area A1. For node 2 opposite triangle area is called as a A2. Similarly for node 3 opposite triangle area is called as a A3, and total area of this triangle is capital A. Now how to find out the natural coordinate? Now for this triangular element, we define L1, L2 and L3, three natural coordinates. So L1 is calculated by, so it is a area A1 opposite to node 1 divided by total area. So A1 divided by E. Now L2 is equal to, this is the area A2 divided by total area, means A2 divided by A, so that is L2. And L3 is similarly E3 divided by A. Now here also the L1 is equals to shape function N1, L2 is equal to shape function N2, and L3 is equal to shape function N3. So these natural coordinates can be used to find out the shape functions also. Now from the geometry we can define A1 plus A2 plus A3, area of these three triangles equal to total area of the full triangle. So from this geometrical relation we can find out L1 plus L2 plus L3 is equal to 1, means summation of this natural coordinate is equal to 1, means A1 plus A2 plus A3, that is equal to A divided by A, we will get a 1. Now here also for point P, coordinates X and Y which can be find out by using this formula: L1 X1 plus L2 X2 plus L3 X3. Similarly, Y is equal to L1 Y1 plus L2 Y2 plus L3 Y3. So these natural coordinates simplifies the terms which is having shape functions. So it is easy for the calculation. In the next video, we will see about three-dimensional natural coordinates and benefits of the natural coordinates. Thank you. Subscribe for more videos in finite element analysis.